Hey everybody, this is Perch. Let's see, we got a viewer mail here. I think this is a response to, are comic books dying? Which a lot of people say all the time. Are they dying? Well, again, no. But it kind of depends on what you mean. By the way, somebody asked a question. Volby, the guy who was all over for that Hellboy sales analysis, had asked for a, which comics get reprint or localized more, translated more in markets, manga or Western comics? And if you've been wondering that, the answer is both. It depends on the comics. I would say as a whole, probably, I don't even know. You know, it's actually, the percentages are so small that it's hard to say. The answer is the really, really popular manga stuff, One Piece, Demon Slayer, Spy X Family, some of that stuff, the recent stuff, that's getting localized all over the fucking place. But there are hundreds, if not thousands, of manga titles that are being produced in Japan, and only in Japan. They never go anywhere. So, I mean, I don't know what that percentage would be. Less than 5% probably is being localized. But when it is localized, it goes big. And the same exact thing is kind of true of Western comics. The monthly floppies are not being localized much at all. I mean, they do go to other markets, but not massively. But collections, things like Scott Pilgrim, things like Dark Knight Returns, Civil War, some of those books, they get localized everywhere. So just like the manga does. So it really just kind of depends on what's popular is the answer. Manga, as much as that's been a talking point, it's still a pretty finite amount of manga that gets out of Japan, you know. But anyway, this mail says, loving the channel and your obviously insane takes. Well, thank you very much. RB sucks. I like to think of myself as being balanced in my views, especially in the industry I'm so lucky to be involved in. The title of the video, Are Comic Books Dying, instantly makes me respond, of course not, that's ridiculous. However, on closer inspection of Comic Storian's presentation, it was obvious that the title should have been, Are American Comic Books Dying? Which, in fairness, I would also think is a little ridiculous. I think that's a good, by the way, that's good. The way you've divided that up is true. And I think, look, it's ridiculous in both counts, but it's less ridiculous in one. And maybe the actually perfectly accurate statement would be, are some of the big American publishers dying? And the answer is, yeah, some are. Okay, but back to the mail. I wondered if you've seen the video or not. I did see the video. Enough people pointed me to it, and I saw it. I think your take is correct. I think it was mistitled, and again, it's trying to weave too much. What's your response, back to the mail, what's your response to the research and commentary was? For myself, I feel he, Comic Storian, although having a healthy attitude to what he's reading and his approach to interaction with a wider audience is missing something and maybe even a little blinded to some issues relating to his research on the physical numbers. Anyway, I'd be tempted to your opinions. Thanks for giving me a beacon of sanity in a world so full of teeth gnashing. Thank you very much. I think, so the problem with the numbers is I feel like when you go into them, you have to explain your bias and the math you're using. Because truth be told, you can make that math go any direction you want. Any way you want. There's really not a one-size-fits-all answer to the question of how are comics doing, are they successful? I think that, and plus, people tend to look at it from a single point in time. It's a much more valuable conversation if you can look at it more, the word is holistically, but look at comic books more, more for, how are they doing relative to previous years? How are they doing in regards to, there's a lot more to it than just how do comic books look in 2023? The answer is, not great. But, again, it's all a little relative. So I think when I watched that video and I'm seeing his take, I think it's reasoned, but it unfortunately it's making the mistake I think a lot of people make, which is it falls into the trap of trying to either prove or disprove the current almost culture war bias about comics being successful or not. it doesn't explain that, hey, you know, there's a bunch of factors here that have changed comics. The pricing, where they're distributed, the strength of the direct market, what's changed with publishing, all that kind of stuff that really does matter. And I think it's trying to play to a, you know, extreme. Meaning, are comic books going to die next year? Well, no. Are comic books doing better than they ever have before? Well, no. So if you can get that out, then I think you get into a healthier place. And in my opinion, he didn't really get there. He showed some numbers, but the bias was basically to say, hey, those people who say comic books are dying, they're wrong. That was kind of the thesis that he was going for. And I get nothing wrong with that, but that leaves a lot of stuff on the table. It basically ignores kind of, you know, some of the issues that are a big problem in comics. Now, I mean, he gave some attention to it. Comic Historian, I think, tries to do, you know, I mean, look, he's got a big YouTube channel. He makes a lot of money off that. He's got a vested interest in keeping it going. Seems to be a fairly reasonable dude. He's not like some of the other lunatics out there. There's plenty of absolutely awful people on all fronts who are just making shit up and going at it. So I think he tried to give a good approach to it. But I think what we have to do is get to a place where I can say, or somebody could say, yeah, comic books aren't terribly healthy. Or hell, why even caveat that way? Comic books aren't healthy. How do we make it healthy? What are the factors driving it to, you know, to unhealthy behavior? And I think I'll throw this out there for those of you who talk a lot about, you know, the social aspects of comics. The comics are appealing to a niche audience, that it's the comic books are going more for, you know, woke content or so on. I would argue this, and it's been an argument you've heard me make before. If there was more money, if there was more to lose in these comics, meaning, you know, if they were distributed in more places, they had more exposure, people knew they existed more, they had, you know, there's more money in it, so that you were hiring, you know, higher talent, they were generating more money, which meant it, you know, if all those things were true, you would see those problems. You would see the weird, cringy Twitter speak go down, because it you know, comic books wouldn't be something that attracted people at the bottom end of a career, which by and large, and no offense, a lot of people who listen to this are in comics. Keep in mind that there are those of you who are lifers, who love the industry, love what's, love the storytelling aspect, and, you know, I salute you. You're wonderful people. There's also people in comics who are trying to make their way, you know, make a living and make their way up the chain. Comics is step one on a three-step plan into Hollywood or wherever they're planning to go. And those, for those people, it really is, you're really kind of at the, not bottom of the barrel, I think that's too cruel, but you're at the beginnings of their career. And if comic books made more money, generated more money, pushed more stuff out for people, then you'd have more higher paid people wanting to stay in comics because it was good for their finances. But very, very few people are in comic books for their finances, meaning nobody. I mean, you either have to have a passion for it or just starting on your career hoping to make more money down the road. But by and large, people do not go into comics for their pocketbook. And because of that, you're getting more casual care to the stories that are written. You're getting, you know, less attention from editorial. I mean, all these things stack up. And so I think you might argue it's a chicken and egg problem, and you're not wrong. Like, well, yeah, but if the Twitter stuff went away in comics, if that kind of dialogue, you know, vanished, then more audiences would come and then more money would be there. So do you solve that first, or do you put the money in first? Whatever. I mean, yeah, you're right. There's a chicken and egg problem for sure. But overall, comics aren't healthy. And that's not a bad word. It's not a dirty thing. That doesn't, you know, that's not shitting on the industry. I get that if you work in comics, you don't want to hear that. You know, if you, the person listening to this, works for an insurance company and somebody says insurance companies are dying, you know, you're going to feel scared and defensive. That's normal. But at least for me, I don't think, you know, bad news doesn't get better over time. It doesn't age well. So it's better to just, you know, bite the bullet a little bit and start to figure out, how do we solve this? How do we improve the situation? which you've heard me say before. Overall, again, I think the analysis is good, but too much of it was based on the premise of, are the people who are saying comics are dying wrong? If you're coming at it from that perspective, it's like you're trying to prove that argument incorrect, as opposed to, you know, really kind of looking at where the industry's actually at. I also think Comic Storian, I mean, he's a big guy and makes a lot of money, is connected from the industry's perspective. And, you know, if one way to piss off those connections, if you want to stop getting those free comics, if you want to, you know, get people, you know, crapping on you, saying you're a member of the, you know, new Nazi party, saying comics are, you know, are suffering, that there's problems, is a very fast way to get people hating you. And so I would understand why you want to dodge that. You know, unless you're mean, you just don't give a fuck. Anyway, thank you very much for the mail. What do you guys think of all this? Let me know in the comments below, and thanks for listening.